big time. Oh my gosh, they're not running off. I'm gonna get another shot.
From that.
Yeah, that's fresh hair. Some Impala hair, blood all right here.
Just came right through here. Oh, I think that's it. There she is, it was a kill shot. That makes me so much happier. This is amazing. Day 15, I've been waiting for this since day one.
That was a bullseye. I can't believe this.
Man, I don't even know what to do right now. I really do honor this animal. My intentions for getting this girl right here was to sustain my own life and to pass that threshold of surviving into the highest level of what it means to thrive.
The liver, I'd say it's a little bit bigger than the duck liver, huh? Who needs frog wah? Last but very not least, it's an Impala heart. And in honor of this animal and in South Africa, this heart goes to the hunter. Absolutely thankful for this animal. I've lived a lifetime in one day today. I'm speechless, man.
Impala vagina on my head. Slow and steady wins this race. All that matters is that next step. One foot in front of the other. Hyena's gonna have to fight me for this one. And I am just about back to my camp. Let's do it right over here. Ah. Oh, baby. You know, this meat is more than enough to get me to extraction day and beyond. I've got to keep in mind that this is still a very wild and dangerous environment. I've got a ton of meat and blood in the area, which is going to bring in bigger predators. Whatever meat I don't consume tonight, I have to put it up in a tree as high as possible.
Hell yeah. Hear that? That's a beautiful heart. It's about to replenish my heart. And chef's gonna enjoy the fruits of his labor, commitment, persistence.
The first cooked heart steaks right here. This is gonna take me a while to eat this.
I just finished between 2 and 3 pounds of heart, backstrap, and liver. I ate everything. It was delicious, but I'm in a coma. After all that Impala meat, I can't move. I still have to maintain this fire, and I'm so tired, I can't even keep my eyes open. I think I'm in a coma. Like, for real. bees are going insane. Something or a pack of somethings is down at the tree right now. Everything's gone a little quiet. Ooh. I almost thought I could hear the carcass getting pulled out of the tree. I can hear bones breaking. I hope it's not a leopard. That cat is my biggest fear. It's day 16.
Feeling good.
I was sworn I heard something down here last night. You can see the main carcass is still up there, but two of the legs are gone. The hindquarter leg and one front leg are gone.
No flies, but the ants definitely found their way.
Oh, it's all fresh, though, still. This is amazing.
So the plan worked, wrapping it in the hide.
So I'm gonna be eating steaks for the next 3 days and probably biltong for the last day and biltong snacks all the way to extraction.
There we go, that's a good strip.
To make biltong, or jerky, Brian will have to dry the meat for around 8 hours in the sun until all the moisture is removed so it can't spoil.
I'm gonna have to keep the rest of it away from any predators.
Might bury it. Got nice, soft, cold mud to work with here. Decent elephant footprint here. That is cold down there. That mud is cold. And if it's protected by the animal skin, then I could bury it, put some more clay on top of it. It'll stay cold, it'll stay absolutely preserved.
Wouldn't even know that's there.
Pretty humble guy, but this is brilliant.
This is my reward. Now let me show you. This is all biltong. It's about 5 pounds of dried meat. I know it's a risky move, but I'm chancing keeping the meat inside my shelter. I'm gonna keep that fire roaring. But man, I am full and tired. I gotta lay down.